Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. You're joining me in the flight deck of the Fenix A320, and in this video we're going to look at the taxi in and parking procedures. So we've just come off the runway 06 at Edinburgh, and we've crossed the whole short line. Normally we would keep the aircraft moving. Usually air traffic control will give us a quick instruction to proceed to our gate, but for the purposes of talking through what we need to do, I have stopped the aircraft here. And also in your simulator operations you will find that it's sometimes quite a challenge to find all the various click spots around the aircraft for the various things we need to adjust. So it's worthwhile just stopping briefly, configuring the aircraft, and then moving on. So after landing checks, begin with disarming the ground spoilers. We then adjust our exterior lights on the overhead panel. So we take the strobes off once clear of the runway, landing lights off. We don't need the nose wheel turn off because we're not in low visibility operations and can see quite well today. Nose wheel comes from takeoff to taxi, which is the middle position there. Then we want to come down and make sure the weather radar is off. Then we configure our flaps. If the temperature on the ground is plus 30 degrees Celsius, you want to leave flaps 1 out. I'll cover that off in a different video on hot weather operations. If we have snow or slush on the taxiway, I would leave flaps extended so we can conduct a check at the gate there to ensure that there's no ice stuck in the flap system before retracting them, as that can cause damage. So do bear that in mind. But today, none of those, so we can select flap 0. I then put the transponder into standby, turn off our traffic alert and resolution advisory system. We then come up and turn on the APU. Wait 3 seconds between master and start. And we start a timer for that as well. And it's also a good idea to bear in mind time after coming off the runway, as you can perform a single engine taxi once you've had 3 minutes since use of high power engine thrust, and that doesn't include idle reverse power. So if you used full reverse thrust, as soon as you idle that, the clock starts. We then configure anti-ice as required, so anti-ice off, we're not in visible moisture, and the temperature on the ground is now plus 15. Then there's the after landing checklist, which is radar and predictive wind shear off, which is confirmed there on the ECAM. Now it's a good idea to monitor your brake temperatures here. So the highest I have down here at the moment is 145 degrees. You'll get an ECAM generally above 300 degrees, the hot brakes. We need to bear in mind our turnaround when it comes to use of brake fans. If you have high temperature, your brake fan is up here. First of all, wait for 5 minutes before using the brake fan. See what the temperatures are doing. They do take a while to increase. Also, if you do use the brake fan, you cannot depart until the brake temperatures are below 150 degrees, whereas if we don't use brake fans, we can depart with the brake temperatures below 300 degrees. But in any case, you do want to try and turn the brake fans on if you need them before pulling onto stand, as it does blow a lot of brake dust out of the brakes, which isn't great for the ground crew. So with those things completed, we can now taxi in. Now, we have got more than 3 minutes elapsed, so we can go single engine now. So what we'll do is shut down engine 2. And we'll come over to the overhead panel, and we turn on the electric hydraulic pump, which is on the yellow system. Let's confirm that's shutting down. And we'll look left, and clear right side, we'll taxi in. Release our parking brake. The aircraft does taxi nicely on a single engine. You don't need too much thrust. The issue is my nose wheel sensitivity settings. Always having a look, so clear left side. And clear right side. We want to keep the N1 value is below 30% on the taxi. Okay, we'll pull on to the next stand. Stand is looking clear. So there's a few things for what we do before we're pulling on stand. First of all, already mentioned the brake fans. Do they need to come on now or not? And then we want to take the nosewheel light off. At this stage, we've also had the APU running for long enough to be able to select the bleed on, which is 3 minutes. If you do have a guidance system, which you'll see up here, you want to make sure before you pull on to stand that the correct aircraft type is displayed. Okay, pull on to stand, parking brake is set. A quick check that the APU is on, which it is. And we can now turn off engine one. So engine one master to off. I'll normally wait till the M1 is below 5% and you can take the beacon off. And with that we can release the cabin, the seatbelts off. So turning the beacon off signals to the ground crew that they can approach the aircraft, so you only want to do that when it's safe to do so. So quick check of the exterior lights, that's all set as they should be. The nav lights stay on if the aircraft's still electrically powered. So we have the APU providing power at the moment, and the aircraft is occupied as well, so we keep the nav lights on. So we confirm radar and predictive wind shear is all off, but we confirm that we have the park brake set, and we do that on ECAM. Confirm the engines are off. We can now turn off our fuel pumps, and we no longer need the electric hydraulic pump, so that can come off. Ground power is now available, so we can connect that, and then we can take the APU offline. I normally wait till the cabins are pretty empty before doing that, and it all depends on your turnaround status, whether you want APU on and the conditions outside. So if it's a hot day, you've got a short turnaround, you're going to leave the APU on. Some airports obviously won't like you doing that for noise reasons, so do bear that in mind. But we have external power connected. We're going to presume the cabin has been vacated, so I'm going to turn the APU off now. At this point we'll conduct fuel checks. We can also check the status of our IRS units and make sure that they're all within tolerance still and they haven't drifted. If they have, we'd log those in the maintenance logbook. And obviously we would record any other defects with the aircraft at this point as well. To secure the aircraft, we would come up and we'll turn our IRS units off. 1, 2 and 3. Crew oxygen will come off. Emergency exit lights will come off once all the passengers have left the aircraft. And then at this point, we'd turn the batteries off. And if we disconnected the external power now, the aircraft will go cold and dark. And there we go. So that's the taxi in and parking checks in the Airbus A320. If you have any questions on any of that, please drop them into the comments. And don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one. Thanks for watching.